Lots of reasons that even conventional growers are looking at how to incorporate mechanical cultivation into their production systems. The amount of money still being spent on hand weeding at this scale is considerable. And so looking at ways to integrate some of these mechanical cultivation tools to limit that expense as labor scarcity becomes a truer and truer reality for more growers is going to be imperative. What was unique about the 2016 growing season in this area? Drought. Now, how about this spring? What was unique about this spring and early summer weather-wise? Wet and cool for most of us. All right, so there are times even when you can be using herbicides that the environmental conditions are not going to lend themselves to them working the way that they were designed to work.
So integrated weed management aims to help us integrate more weed management tactics into our production, and I think another name for integrated weed management would be don't put all your eggs in one basket. If you're relying solely on one management tactic and it fails you, then you can have a severe yield loss. So what we need to do is integrate in more weed management tactics to prevent that from happening.
Looking at buying a new cultivator, make sure to get one that's the same number of rows as your planter. So that way, let me just talk about the planter. When you're going down, say you have an 8-row planter, or I guess a 5-row planter in my case, and I go down, all of these rows are fixed. And then when I come back, they're still fixed, but the distance between the border rows is not. It's uneven. So if you go over that with a cultivator, you're going to be taking out some of your crop. So in my case, I want a 5-row cultivator.
A duro gives you a disc and a side knife, and you can run within a half to 3/4 of an inch of either side of the row. So and this is for direct seeded crops, you're getting that clean, you know, early on, and then as soon as the crop will pass the cut test where it's holding in, you can go ahead and apply the finger weeders to it. And you know, with most direct seeded crops are going to be about this tall. Transplants may be a little bigger because it takes transplants longer to root in, and so you're going to go through there with that, and however many passes you want to do to get yourself to a maturity where either the weed competition doesn't matter or it's too short a time for it to go to seed from then until harvest time when you're going to plow it up.
It looks out on an angle, again, 2 meters in front of the machine. It identifies the center of each plant as it's coming down. And on the monitor inside, you will see a little green cross appear on each plant as the camera recognizes it. The rule of thumb is we can do 6 plants per second weeding with it. So it really is a labor saver. It doesn't get tired, doesn't very often miss. The bigger units on this can be, let's say, 4 or 5 rows on the front, 4 or 5 rows on each side. If this was a 10-inch spacing machine, it would still have 4 cameras. Just have a lot more rows. So. We can go down to a 10-inch wide row while we're cultivating, and we have to have 8 inches in between the plants.
There's a lot of ways that you can give your crop an advantage over the weeds, you know, placing your fertilizer in the crop row where it's benefiting the crop and not the weeds in between the rows. Crop rotation, changes in the timing of disturbance. There are a ton of these little hammers, these little ways where you can give your crop an advantage over the weeds. And all of them, I think, make herbicides and they make cultivation that much more effective.